To the ones who say, I worship false idols. How does it feel to know that my worship of these gods is saying that the god you worship is false? Doesn't really make you feel good, does it?
So, you know the story about that girl that got cursed and turned into a crab, so when the gods felt bad, so they put her in the sky as crab.
Will you take a video of me?
What's up, guys? So if you want something that is a pagan-y, cool little movie to watch for Halloween today or any day, if you love George Romero, then I would definitely recommend watching Season of the Witch. I'd say it's a more positive look on paganism because it is about a housewife who discovers witchcraft. That's the beginning and end of it, that she meets a local witch that lives close to where she lives, and she thinks that maybe that's for her too. It's actually one of the most realistic looks into witchcraft that I've ever seen on film, and even has an initiation at the end of the movie. So if that sounds pretty cool to you, and if you like George Romero, definitely check out The Season of the Witch. Outside of the horror elements of her nightmares that she has, there's really nothing horror related about it. Even George Romero said that it's not really a horror movie, it just has occult figures and stuff in it. He didn't really consider it a horror movie. So if you want something pagan-y, I definitely recommend George Romero's Season of the Witch.
The least qualified person to understand a dream is the dreamer, which brings us to you.
Jeez, Tony, you scared the hell out of me.
Durable knives, they're all witches' tools, you know.
Oh, I'm just interested in it.
I don't know. You're the one.
I'm a witch.
Son of a...
Blessings to you, greatest to you. And we thank you today for life and love in the home. Dear Goddess, we thank you for our homes, for you have given that to us as a blessing. And may our homes always be held together and strong. And through the storms, may we always still be together. Hail and blessings to you, great goddess. And we thank you again today.
Is it worth it?
Oh, yeah, it's worth it. If you're strong enough.
Some spiritualities say that the gods can inhabit the statues as we pray or worship them, that they can come inside of a statue. And just watching this statue on some days, it almost has me convinced of that, because this is one of the most expressive statues that I have. There are days that I'm talking and it looks like she's smiling, and I can tell you that there are days when there's something happening and it doesn't look like she's smiling anymore. So it's just an interesting thing that always has me thinking about that, of what I said, that how gods can inhabit a statue. This one always makes me feel like she may be listening, because she's sometimes happy, and when I look over at her, sometimes her face does not look happy.